join a boy band. KFC sponsors SMTV.
Have we got an exciting show for you today? Not only have we got Zoe and Hayley from Pop Idol, we've also got S Club Junior's Star Wars Spider-Man, and it's also the very first day for our brand new presenters, and they should be here any second. Brian's just bringing them from reception.
Guys, this way it's not far. Oh, I can't believe you're both starting. Today is going to be so brilliant. Hope you've had the post-bag dance. But she know better than me. What am I saying? It's in here. No, oh, here we go. Studio Tess is so excited, guys. Come on. No, back off, back off. No, go, go.
Have we got time to go to the toilet?
Yes, H, don't
worry. We're not going to be late, are we?
No,
Claire,
we're not going to be late. We're fine. Oh, here we go. Studio, come on.
As I said, they should be here any minute. Hope they haven't got lost. Brian, where are you?
Yeah, hi, Tess, it's me. We're in the studio, but, you know, it feels a lot smaller than usual.
I found the light.
Oh, we're going to be a little bit longer. Bye.
Look, I really need the toilet.
Don't start. And you either.
Get a move on, Brian. The show started a minute ago. It's getting embarrassing. He's giving them the full tour. I'm sure they'll be here any minute.
You know, they must have changed one of the signs. It's not my fault, but I know we're going now. We're going down here. Oh, God. No, wrong way. I know we're going now. I'm so dead. In there. Quickly, get in, studio. Oh, no!
This is ridiculous. What on earth are they up to? I'm dialing him.
There's a funny looking sink. They haven't actually got taps or anything. What are they for?
Not my family relationship. It's Tess. Hello? Yeah, sorry, Tess. Hi. Yeah, I know we've to open the show. And H has been to the band. I know, but he can't. Okay, hold on. Sorry, H, you don't mind. It's Tess.
Oh.
She's so angry.
Here's the fantastic S Club Juniors with their first single, One Step Closer.
I'm
That was the S Club Juniors, and look, everybody, they eventually made it. It's Claire and Ava. And this is a Saturday morning squad to give them a huge welcome with the SMTV wave.
Oh, what a noise! Reminds me of being in Steps.
Oh, all your fans screaming.
No, the five of us trying to do harmonies.
We thought you were great and you're going to be even better as presenters on the show.
Yes.
Come on.
Thank you. Okay, so here's what's coming up on the rest of today's brilliant show.
The Men in Black will be tackling more alien life form at 9:35.
Do you fancy meeting WWF's biggest superhero, The Rock? Well, you can if you win today's Men in Splat.
We have an exclusive report from the set of the new Star Wars movie at 10 past 10.
Hayley and Zoe from Pop Idol are here to answer your email questions and queries at 10:15.
Win a trip to the Hollywood premiere of Spider-Man at 10:20.
Meg Ryan tells me all about a new movie at 10:25.
In tests, 8 out of 10 owners said their battery guards were more intelligent than Brian. See for yourself at 10:40.
We're next for Nurse Emma Ridge and Roger. Casually, the clinic opens its doors at 10:45.
And 3SL, Gareth Gates and Kylie Minogue will all be here with Kat for CD UK at 11 o'clock.
Show we have for you this morning, and on top of all that, you can also win to win.
And now for today's prize. How do you fancy having S Club Juniors round your house? Morning, guys. Say hello.
They're in our house.
There's a lot of them.
Well, if you ring to win, the band will come to your home, teach you the dance routine, and perform their brand new single live in your very own living room. There's loads of other goodies too, and we'll be filming it all for SMTV in a couple of weeks.
Nice.
All you have to do if you want to ring to win is answer this following question. What is the name of S Club Junior's new single? Is it One Step Closer, One Step Further, or One Step Beyond? If you think you know the answer, phone us on 0901 070 9090. Calls cost 30p.
30.
And remember to ask permission from whoever pays the bill.
And don't forget S Club Junior's. Woo! Studio today, so if there's anything you want to ask them or us, you can email your questions to studio@smtvlive.co.uk.
Or you can contact us through our website at itv.com/CITV. Just click on postbag or text us on 07740700900.
But now here are two superstars you would never ever catch without wearing a black tie. It's Men in Black.
Later, and don't forget, there's a chance for you to win a fantastic prize in our rather violent SMTV game, Men in Splat.
Here come the men in splat. Let's hope they don't surrender.
This morning we are giving you and three friends the chance to meet WWF superstar The Rock. How cool is that? I love The Rock. And a private screening of his new film, Scorpion King, which is released on April the 19th. I'm going to get you, Brian. I'm going to get you. And you'll have to be 12 years old to see it.
And manning the inning splatter today, we have Zoe and Haley from Pop Idol. And their mission is to find our celebrity spotters uptown, left and right, and bag as many of those funny-looking creatures as you can.
Taking care to avoid me. Here!
Oh, it's not you I'm after, H. If you'd like to play Men in Splat this morning, all you have to do is answer this question. In which film did The Rock first play the Scorpion King? Was it A, The Mummy Returns, B, The Daddy Returns, or C, Many Happy Returns? To my mum, who's 21 again today. Happy birthday, Mum! If you think you know the answer, give us a ring on 0901 070 9090. Calls cost 30p unless you're calling from outside the galaxy, and you must get permission from whoever pays the bill.
And we've still got loads more to come on this morning's show, so try not to get abducted by aliens until the end of the show, and we'll see you in just a few moments.
Why did the chicken?
Welcome back to SMTV Live, and guess what time it is?
What?
It's time for the postbag.
Oh yes, wait a minute, Mr. Postbag.
better than me.
Hey, just bring out the old dance moves now. Like that.
Pull it out of the bag.
Surprise. Last month, we asked you to send us in your dirty, filthy, disgusting photographs for a Mucky March competition to win a fantastic Dyson washing machine. Ooh. And the response we had was absolutely massive. Now, today's the day when we ask you, the viewers, to phone in and vote for a winner out of our three finalists. Before we show you our three finalists, let's take a look at some of those photographs we didn't get a chance to see, and let's see if you can spot yourself. Disgusting. I think everyone that sent in photographs deserves a big cheer. But now, this is the moment of truth when we ask you, the viewers, to phone in and pick a winner from our three finalists. And first up, we have Ben, Pete, Lee, James and Daniel for Croaky Trill. And if you want them to win, you can call for them on 0901 566 0101.
Dirty people.
Very dirty.
Secondly, it's little Shaznay Longdin from Corby in North Ants. If you want to vote for Shaznay, the number is 0901 566 0102.
Finally, we've got Matthew Stevens from Winsford in Cheshire. Wow. Wow. If you want to vote for Matthew, get voting now on 0901 566 0103, you dirty boy!
So come on, guys, get voting now! And we will be announcing the winner at the end of the show.
Yes, indeed. Keep your letters, emails and text messages rolling in. You can contact us at SMTV Live, PO Box 22122, London, SE1 9GL.
Still to come today, more from Zoe and Hayley from Popeye. From the set of Star Wars Attack of the Clones, and your chance to fly to Los Angeles for the premiere of the new Spider-Man movie.
That's a goodie.
But right now, it's time for the second half of Men in Black.
Yeah. Hello, P.
Oh, I'm quite comfortable as I am.
We're Men in Splat. Our mission is to point out the aliens living peacefully among us and say, go back to where you came from, you freaks!
So who are we naming and shaming this week, P?
Simon Cowell. He's an alien.
No!
What do you think his trousers are hiding
there? No!
Will Young, he's an alien.
No.
He says, I'm going to take your love and make it evergreen. Green. Green as a Martian. Green as a bug-eyed freak from the planet Venus.
No.
Michael Jackson.
Oh, well, that one was so obvious.
No, apparently he's human.
No.
Amazing, isn't it?
Well, I'll be skinned and probes. Let's play Men in Splat. Earlier on this morning, we asked you in which movie did The Rock first play the Scorpion King? And the answer, of course, Q was...
The Mummy Returns.
And that's exactly right. That's the exact same answer our caller gave us online this morning. On line one is Stephanie Roberts from Chester. Good morning, Stephanie.
Hiya.
How are you feeling this morning?
Excited.
Have you had your breakfast?
No.
What do I always breakfast. Say? Breakfast is the most important meal of the day. Put that in your head, Stephanie.
I'm so
close. Oh, okay. Did you watch Pop Idol?
Yeah.
Who did you want to win?
Gareth.
That's a pity. Firing for you this morning, we have Hayley. Good morning, Hayley.
Good morning.
How are you this morning?
I'm very well this
Just
morning.
To point out, Duncan from Blue has scored 400. That's what you've got to beat. Are you confident?
Yeah. Come on,
okay.
Stephanie.
Grab your headset, love.
Thank you.
And your glasses as well.
Lovely.
Q, tell us how to play. Ooh.
We'll put 45 seconds on the clock. Each alien paint bag is worth 100 points. The alien spaceship paint bag, which goes back and forth, is worth 300 points. All you have to do is score as many points as you possibly can. Whoever has the most points at the end of the show wins today's star prize.
Okay, it's as simple as that, and good luck to the pair of you. Up, down, left, right, stop, spot, defend the galaxy, go!
Up. Right, left. Left, 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 left
Go home. Get out. Go on. Get...
Oh, I'm
Stephanie,
so sorry.
You scored nothing,
oh,
love. I'm so sorry. Oh.
No wonder you didn't win Pop Idol. Oh.
Shame you, Hank.
For those alien Tommies, the galactic war is over. But hey, for every alien we splat, there's another to take its place.
Oh, he's so right. And we'll see you in just one more moment for more Men in Splat. Welcome back to the Men in Splat! Yes, earlier on, Stephanie got...
nil point.
That's exactly where our next caller has to beat, and I believe on line two we have Russell Bedford from Hampshire. Good morning, Russell.
Good morning.
How are you feeling this morning?
A little bit nervous, but I'm fine.
Have you had your breakfast?
Yep.
Good boy. Did you watch Pop Idol?
Some of it.
Who did you want to win?
Darius.
That's a pity. Firing for you is Zoe. Wrong answer. Zoe, how are you feeling this morning?
I'm feeling confident. Come on, Russell.
Now, Hayley wasn't that good, was she? You going to do better?
We're going to do better.
Let's
do
it.
This.
Headset
do this.
And glasses.
Okay, let's go.
There we go. Headset first. You know what you're doing. And then your glasses. H, tell us how to play.
45 seconds on the clock. Up, down, left, right, stop, splat. You have nil point to beat. Defend the galaxy and go!
Right.
Well done, Zoe. Round of applause for Zoe. I see the force is strong in that one. There'll be more from Men in Splat next week. But stay tuned because over the next few weeks, SMTV will be bringing you a series of behind-the-scenes reports from Star Wars, Attack of the Clones. And here's the first, Defend the Galaxy. Go!
You know, and someday I'm gonna fly away from this place.
You think I'm still the little boy that you first met? When the truth is, I've changed. I'm grown up.
Whenever you're casting, first of all, you're always looking for a really good actor, somebody that really has a lot of craft and is really very talented.
Action!
Who fits the part that you've created.
For the role of Anakin, we had a formal screen test.
102, take one, Mark.
To be honest, I went in with no expectations. I really wasn't thinking that, you know, ooh, I really want this part. It was just, wow, you know, that's George Lucas. This is cool.
And in this particular case, I was looking for somebody who was very boyish and young, but had sort of a James Dean sullen edge to him.
Annie.
Anakin. Annie makes me sound like a little boy.
You look at those eyes and there's just so much happening there. Hayden had all the elements of the character.
Don't try to grow up too fast.
Star Wars Attack of the Clones report next week, but right now it's time to meet the first of today's star guests. But before we do, let's see these two pop idols in action.
Get your troubles, come on, get at me. Chase your cares away. Shout hallelujah, get happy for the judgment day.
Come on, please welcome Hayley and Zoe.
Your name's wrong. We've had loads of emails in for you today. Oh. So I'm going to start with the first one. And this is from Hannah Rollinson. And it's, what was the best part about the whole Pop Idol experience for you?
Ooh. There's loads of good bits. I really liked
at the premiere.
We got to go to Black Hawk Down premiere, didn't we? Mm. And that was
got all glammed up.
Photographer. You look really scared.
What bite you?
What bite you? Well, not very much anyway.
Well, not unless you ask me to.
Okay, right, I've got a question from Susan Grogan. And this is quite a saucy one, actually. And she says, did either of you ever fancy Simon Cowell?
choose your words.
No.
No. It would be nice.
Is there any reasons, though?
just like these things
the harness
here,
of the trousers, really.
The trousers. The famous trousers.
Yeah. So, no.
Not good in the trouser department, then, no. Carry on,
Colin. Okay. Who's this from? Oh, Lisa. Don't know where she's from. Who was your idol when you were both growing up? You must have had one.
Mine was Whitney Houston.
I love tell that.
Mine was Madonna.
Mm.
Did you dress up in the 80s with all the gloves and the...
The gloves and the football skirts.
Rah-rah skirts.
How old I am, you see.
Right, see, one of my favourite records was Borderline.
Oh, yeah. Very
what's
classic.
I
think Lucky Star.
Lucky Star. Can we have a little rendition, please?
Oh,
come on.
Really?
You're a best friend, man.
Okay.
Oh.
Lovely.
Moving on. Okay. This is from Gemma Borum. And is it true that the last night of the Pop Idol tour, you all played pranks on each other?
Yeah. Yes. We did.
Come on, share.
It's you.
It's tradition, isn't it?
Oh yeah.
What did you do? The one on the big band's part of the show, Darius has to play first three keys on the piano.
Can you play piano?
No.
No. So
he's got numbers. Okay. He's got numbers
on the piano.
Okay.
And we all move them around. So invited.
Good one.
But lots of different stuff. Dancers done the dances back to front and stuff, and it was
brilliant.
Do you know what they did to me? They stripped me and pushed me in an elevator. That's what they did. Thank you very much. Thank you very much.
Okay, this one is from Shaz, and she said, "What were you both miss most about the tour?
Performing and being
together, being the whole 10 of us all together."
Because we were all together like for 21 dates, we weren't getting evicted and we were like in the competition. So we were all together and
spent some time together.
Performing for the whole and thousands of people as well.
It must have been hard. I mean, I'm stuck with Claire, so.
Okay. Okay, finally, I'm sorry, there's this question we all need to know the answer to. Is it true that Zoe's going out with Gareth? And that's from Claire Brown.
No, it's not, no. We are the best of friends. We keep in touch daily and stuff. And, but no.
Much the same as me and H.
No, really. not at all, I'm afraid. Okay. Oh.
Thank you, girls, for chatting to us. Thank you very much.
Aww.
Hey, everybody. To watch out for them in Casually the Clinic at 10:50. We'll see you in a couple of minutes with Meg Ryan and the chance for you to go to the Spider-Man premiere in Hollywood. See you in a bit.
So I built the cup with cocoa pops right to the top. Look what you can win when they saw the milk and chocolate on the big screen. You couldn't stop the gold pouring in. Part of a nutritious breakfast of crisp chocolatey pops taste magic.
I think this was the turning point.
See, they turn their milk really chocolatey, so
we'd rather have a bowl of cocoa pops.
TV Live. Now, the brand new Spider-Man movie is due to be released here on June the 14th. They love doing that. And to celebrate...
You, I thought you'd finished in the middle, bless her. Let's see if Jill Stars can do any worse.
Oh, I'm so happy. I don't know what to say.
Matron.
She's in pain.
Well, let's just see. Come on, let's see if Elise Harrison can pull it out of the bag.
Go on.
Come on.
Crawl to the top. And thank you for the clouds for showing me how the perfect I'm planning to. Like to thank the person I love the most in the whole wide world, me. Thank me! Thank me, thank you, thank you.
It's all right,
she's fine.
She's just moved me.
It's not like Claire to be dramatic.
She's off there. If you think you can do better than that, record your Oscar speech on 0901 070 0202. Calls should cost no more than 30p. And get permission before you call. Now, don't forget that the Guardian must be over 21 and hold a valid driving license. And you must have passports ready to travel to the US on the 27th of April.
Ooh, Claire Richards there. Come on, a round of applause. Oh, I can see. And speaking of Hollywood superstars, Meg Ryan's been talking to our Tess about her latest film, Kate and Leopold. Was she nice?
She was lovely. She's like one of my heroes. I was so excited to meet her.
Did you swap numbers?
No.
No. I'll give it to you later. It stars Hugh Jackman from the X-Men as the dashing Duke Leopold, who travels forward in time to 1876 to 2001 and falls in love with businesswoman Kate, played by Meg. Good. Here's what she told Tess.
Ooh. Would hardly believe that I'm being detained at present in the hereafter, the time to come?
You, of all people, should understand. I mean, you're a scientist.
Where the hell am I?
You're still in New York.
That, sir, is not New York.
I'm afraid it is.
And Meg, I really enjoyed the movie.
Do you like it?
I loved it. It's a real sort of romantic comedy.
His headphones aren't actually plugged into anything.
Oh, I don't listen to music when I'm psyching myself up for Brian's brain, Claire. It's just too much of a distraction.
Then bring up the older grey matter, are we then, Brian? Exercising the old brain?
Oh, golly, yes, Tess, I've actually hired a personal trainer to exercise it for me.
You mean a personal tutor?
No, trainer.
There you go, Bri. We did 100 times around the block, 10 sit-ups, and 40 minutes on the bike.
Cheers, my good man. I'll just nip off and pop the old fella back in.
Oh, Brian! Don't you need your brain in your head at all times so you can, like, breathe and stuff?
Sure. Brian? Welcome to Brian's Brain. Now, this is the part of a show where a member of you lot out there gets to draw up 10 secret questions, the answer to which they and all their mates should know. Then he or she then gets the opportunity to put those questions to SMTV's Brian. Now, he's actually 5-2 down in the series, but he won last time, so he's in a bit of a fighting mood this week. Please welcome Brian Dowling.
Like all that somersaulting stuff.
A little bit frisky at this early hour.
I was
Brian.
Watching the sports channel, all the gymnastic. I'm very good.
Really?
Thank you.
It's a matter of opinion, 5-2 down.
Well, you know, Tess, I mean, we all know and all the general public know that this isn't the strongest part of the show, but that doesn't matter. Like me for who I am, I like you for who you are.
Been swatting, special preparations?
Big team behind me, loads of swatting. I've got this one nailed, but she's a bit full of it, Tess.
Is she confident?
Think she'd slap off that pedestal.
Well, let's see if she's got what it takes. Let's meet our contender. It's 9-year-old Frances Healy.
Tess, even I don't wave like that.
Frances, that was a very regal wave, very confident. You feeling good?
Full of it. Yes.
Not nervous?
No.
Excellent.
Well, she told me she was 1% nervous and 99% confident, full of it.
Not anymore.
What was that, Frances?
Not anymore.
Not anymore?
No.
Don't be nervous. It's all mouth and no trousers. All right, have you got a copy of your questions, please, Frances? Thank you, sweetheart. Now, today, we are playing for the top 10 Disney DVDs. Oh. Hands off, Brian, darling. If Brian answers wrongly, you get a DVD, Francis. If he gets it right, he wins the DVD. Now, at the end of your 10 questions, you can decide to gamble everything you've won on your killer question. Now, if Brian fails to get that answer correct...
Which is quite likely.
You win all 10 DVDs and today's star prize, which is a state-of-the-art DVD player. That's my job to shush it.
Sorry, Tess.
Calm down.
Sorry.
Now, if Brian answers the question correctly, you lose everything, Francis, and we offer it to you, the viewers at home. So you got that? Got that, Francis? Yeah? Brian, remove your earpiece, please.
Yes, do you remember the letter when Kat was leaving? She said that, you know, I had to keep it in just for 1 week.
Kat specifically told me don't let him try any tricks with the earpiece. Get it out!
She gave me the letter.
Get it out. And let's play Brian's Brain. Oh. Question number one, we're playing for DVD number 10. It's Dumbo.
Child's Dream.
First question, please.
What is the name of Liz Hurley's baby?
Damien!
It's a good start. Fear not. Question number two for DVD number 9. It's The Fox and the Hound. Francis.
Who was the US president before George W. Bush?
Bill Clinton.
Do you see
how professional I've been this week? I'm not even letting a little runt get to me. I'm just really like... Next question, please, Francis.
That's all right, because Francis is coming back with question number 3. For DVD number 8, it's the Aristocats. Francis, give him your question.
Who are currently top of the English Premier League?
Manchester United! This one, presuming it's Man United, Arsenal, Chelsea, Plymouth.
We have to take your first answer there, Brian.
It was Arsenal.
And you were wrong. It was Arsenal. It is Arsenal.
Come on!
And they're still able to complete the double of FA Cup and league title this year. But you got it wrong, and Hayley got it right. There you go.
I knew the answer.
Francis got it right. Excuse me. There you go, sweetheart. No, you got it wrong, Brian.
My mic just said Man United.
First answer. Next question, number four, for DVD number 7, it's Sleeping Beauty. Francis, the question, please.
What is a hippo in Rainbow called?
Zippy! George Bongo!
Sorry, Brian, it's actually George.
His friends
are called Zippy, Bongo and Jeffrey.
Oh, Roger Rainbow.
So wrong, Francis, there you go. Question number 5 for DVD number 6.
Silly program, anyway.
Toy Story 2.
Toy.
Which country has the highest population?
China, Japan!
Incorrect. It is China, and it's the world's fourth largest country.
I knew that.
Lucky today, Brian, darling.
I'm full of it today, I will admit.
Question 6, we're playing for DVD number 5, and it's Peter Pan.
The boy who could fly.
Who was the boy that befriended E.T.?
Oh, he brought... I don't know!
Go home. You can go home, Brandon. It was, in fact, Elliot, and it was played by actor Henry Thomas 20 years ago. Unbelievable. That's one for you, Francis.
And Drew Barrymore was a little girl.
She was indeed. You would have got that right.
I would have got that right.
You got that wrong. Question number 7 for DVD number 4. It's Alice in Wonderland. Question number 7, Francis, please.
Little rabbit down the hole.
What unit of measurement are horses measured in?
I didn't hear that. I didn't hear what she said.
What unit of measurement are horses measured in?
Feet, foot, hands!
Sweetheart, it wasn't your first answer.
But I thought I'd fight.
You said feet to start with, and you were wrong. Yeah, bye, Brian. Be a sport. It is a firm hand. And it's 4 inches. You need a firm hand. Sit down.
Was it hands?
It was hands, but it wasn't your first answer. That one is for Francis. Well done, Francis.
Please.
Question number 8, it's for DVD number 3. You like this one, Cinderella 2.
The sequel.
Question number eight, Francis, please.
I can't bear it.
Who in Coronation Street recently had a baby?
Maxine, Tracy Shaw.
He knows his son.
But I really want to know who is the father, Maxine.
She had a baby boy.
I'm saying nothing about that.
Question
she
number nine.
Prematurely as well.
He knows his soaps, doesn't he? Don't even go there in the soaps, Francis.
All right, next time.
Question number nine for DVD number two is Atlantis.
Don't really want that one.
What is the capital of Canada?
Oh, I would not know. Oh, camp, no.
Not a chance.
You see, I was just about to say, Wollongonga. But that country's in Australia, the one I was going to say.
That's a real good job you didn't say that, but now we know you're going to say it anyway.
What is the capital of Canada?
Ottawa.
Oh, yeah!
It's Ottawa, and it was named by Queen Victoria in 1857.
I've got a pen pal
That's
there.
One for you, Francis. Final question, question number 10.
Have to
for
get
DVD
it.
Number one,
Hold
it's
on.
A goodie. Snow White and the Seven Dwarfs.
I've got to get this one.
Get back, Brian.
Hold on. Let's do this.
Let him have it, Francis.
Come on.
In Harry Potter, what is the name of Ron Weasley's pet rat?
I wouldn't know that. I don't know, and I'm going to answer.
Harry Potter always gets you. It was actually Gabbers, so that'll be another one for Francis. Francis, you have done very well. You've won 6 DVDs. Brian Dowling's got...
I got the one I wanted, though.
Now, you can take those 6 home with you now, or you can put them all on your killer question. If you win, Francis, you get all the DVDs and the DVD player. However, if you lose, you go away with nothing. So what do you want to do? What do you think we should do? She should do, everybody.
They're gone!
No! Sorry, they're under the desk. You join us at a very tense moment here on Brian's Brain. Francis has won 6 DVDs and Brian Dowling has won but 4. Francis, can we have your killer question,
okay.
Please?
Hold on.
What is the new Star Wars film called?
Attack of the Clones!
We're going to take everything away from you, Francis. I'm going to offer it to you, the viewers at home. So if you would like to win all of today's prizes, not for you, Brian Dowling, please answer this killer question. Who are the brand new co-presenters of SMTV Live? Is it A, Sonny and Cher, B, H and Claire, or C, Cherie and Blair? If you think you know the answer, give us a ring on 0901 070 9090. Calls cost no more than 30p. And make sure you get permission from whoever pays the bill. And congratulations to Francis, because you did very well. Yeah. Well done. Yeah. You did well. You won 6. We'll have more from Brian's Brain next week. But right now, we've got to run, because it's time for some more medical mayhem in Casually the Clinic.
Owning a tortoise and talking like an idiot does not make you a Blue Peter presenter.
But I've got a badge. Oh, please let me show you how to make an advent calendar with just bits of string.
No, you're delusional. This is a clinic for celebrities, not people who genuinely need help.
I am a celebrity.
Then why aren't the paparazzi taking photos of you?
What paparazzi?
The ones who've snuck into the clinic and hidden all over the place.
Ah, smile for the daily. Oh.
You see? Now, get her out of my sight!
No!
Hello! I'm reporting for work. My name's Emma Ridge. Nurse Emma Ridge.
just been transferred here.
Do you have a reference?
Yes. Sister Sledge wrote one for me.
Nurse Emma Ride.
It's Ridge.
Ridge? Nurse Emma Ridge is an ugly, stupid numpty. Please destroy this letter and here with it.
Ah, oh, she's like a mother to me. It's a shame she died.
Died? You're fitting just fine here, Clothies.
Oh, thanks.
I run this celebrity clinic with Dr. Hollywood. My name is Nurse Ranker.
Really? You must have a nightmare when Jonathan Ross checks in.
He's barred. Now, let me show you the ropes.
Great.
Here they are. Now, I use them to beat the celebrities. If that doesn't work, then there's always my booth of infinite pain.
Oh, that sounds nice, doesn't it, kiddies?
I see. They all crack when the dial's on maximum.
What is it, electric shocks?
No, far worse.
Treatment!
Oh, evil. No, I just like watching people suffer. Spare the cruelty. Spoil the celeb, I say. I despise celebrities. They come in here, pay an extortionate money to have their yin and yangs realigned, and their inner dolphins repoised, and none of it means a thing.
Never made it then.
It was a conspiracy. I should have been in Bananarama. Just because I couldn't sing or dance, that never stopped Jerry Adler.
Or H from Steps.
Ever since that fateful day, I vowed to make their overpaid, overpampered lives a living hell.
Nina, Nina, emergency, emergency! Her IQ is falling and her CV is completely blank. But that's not the worst of it. She's also lost her HEV and she's got a VPL you just would not believe.
Roger! I didn't know you were working here as well.
Yeah, I got the job here when they closed down Guys and Dolls Hospital. We both got fired when Sister Sledge died. It was in her will or something, I don't know.
Yeah. Isn't it great to be free from working for such a cruel, overbearing, sadistic old bag of a witch? Well, it was for a while.
That's enough chatter from you imbeciles. What's wrong with the brain donor?
I've completely lost it. It was like I totally knew where I was going and now I've lost all my artistic direction.
Oh, diddums, haven't those nasty, rusty people at Lukewarm printed a picture of you this week?
No, curse them. I got engaged 15 times this week and they didn't even make the front page of the montage. I need publicity.
Yeah, you little weed. Nurse Ridge, get the electrodes. This celebrity needs electric shock treatment.
No, wait a second. Shouldn't Dr. Hollywood see the patient first?
Did somebody call my name?
Going to puke. I've never seen so much old hair.
I can see you're doubting Roger, but that's okay. We can all be famous, and boy, you're way too ugly to be famous. But one day you'll see the light. One day you'll meet that silver-haired old man in the sky.
Who?
Pete Waterman.
Yes, Pete.
He can make a dog a pop star, and believe me, he has a few times. Say Hollywood, yeah!
Hollywood, yeah!
Lady, I can feel your self-doubt, but I can get you back on that road to stardom. Listen to me, child. Have you got the will?
Yeah!
Have you got the strength?
Yeah!
Have you got the talent?
No!
I know that, child. Remember, this is showbiz. Talent will only hold you back. For it is not written in the holy tabloids. Hollywood! Yeah!
Hollywood! Yeah!
Yes, sir.
Wow, so we bake it in the clinic. Have you got a word for the press?
Yes, I'm marrying Dean Gaffney.
Stone the crows, hold the front page!
Oh, Doctor, you've made me hollow again.
How can I ever thank you?
Oh, just a smile, a kind word, and thank you. 200 grand and maybe a new beard. That's all I ask.
You're not too good for this world.
Hey, listen to that, sister. I'm feeling mighty tired now. I'm going to spend some money. Hollywood! Yeah!
Hollywood!
Never doubt Doc Hollywood. He's genius, as well as being
the man I love.
Ooh. Right, I must disgrace myself with the slaters from EastEnders.
Not so fast. Your treatment's not yet complete.
But Nurse Rugger, this celebrity is cured, surely.
Let's show this. Gotcha.
Oh, Roger.
Emma.
Roger. We thought our days of silly squabbles and nasty backstabbing died with Sister Sledge.
It would seem you were so, so wrong, Emma.
Yes, you were. Deal with it.
No!
Coming up on today's CD UK, we've got performances from H and Claire, 3SL, and Doves. We get all the news from Coldplay and Pink. And if you've ever dreamed of meeting pop goddess Kylie Minogue, then get your pens at the ready for this week's fantastic competition.
That was the fantastic Atomic Kitten with their fab new single. It's okay, Anna. I'm all right, Anna. Thank you.
Looking good there, girls.
Yeah.
And the boys.
And also, the winners of the Ring to Win competition was Vanessa Ball from Birmingham. Congratulations to Vanessa. The winner of Brian's Brain was Claire Smith from Hackney in London. Well done, Claire. She gets all those DVDs and the fantastic DVD player. So congrats to her.
Good prize, well done. And thanks to everybody who voted for the favourite Mookie photo in our Mookie March competition. The votes are now in and we can now reveal the winner. Can we get a drum roll, please? And the winner with a massive 49% of the vote is... Matthew Stevens from Cheshire. So congratulations, Matthew. A brand new wanky washing machine is on its way to you. I'm sure your mum will be very happy.
Well, he looks like he needed that washing machine.
You needed
machine,
it.
Tess. And a big thank you to all of today's fantastic guests. S Club Juniors, Zoe and Haley from Pop Idol, and don't forget the Big Band album is out to buy on Monday from all the 10 finalists. And also a big thank you to 3SL for joining us this morning. Looking forward to the release of the album.
Yes.
All excited?
Yes.
Oh, very good. I'll be buying that.
Oh, yeah.
I'll be buying that.
Best of luck to you guys.
Thank you.
And next week, we're going to be joined by A1, Ronan Keating, and Holly Valance on SMTV Live next week. But now look who's sneaked in. It's Kat Daly of the CD UK audience.
Good morning, audience. And on CD UK this morning, we've got 3SL, we've got Doves, we've got Gareth Gates, and we've also got a very special Kylie Minogue competition. Join me after the break. You know where it's at.
Why did the chicken cross the road? To watch the grannies rock and roll. KFC sponsors SMTV.
We've live coverage of the qualifying session for the San Marino Grand Prix in half an hour after a slightly shorter edition of CD UK.
I'm red, I'm red, I'm ties ahead, I'm fizzy, 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 I'm off my head. Whether you're dressed or in the nuddy, I'm your cocker, your pal and your bestest buddy. This week, down the beach, refresh your head, ties are sponsors CD UK.
CD UK. We may be shorter than usual, but we're not scrimping on quality. Today we've got new boy band 3SL and indie stars Doves. We'll be finding out if Gareth Gates has made it 4 weeks at the top, and we'll be giving you the chance to meet Kylie Minogue. But to get the party started, some true pop heavyweights. They may be no strangers to the City UK stage, but this is their debut as a duo with the infectiously catchy DJ. It's our very own Rachel Clare. Pink has told CD UK she and Britney Spears are actually the best of friends. So if you thought the Britney name check in Pink's new single was a diss, think again. Tired of being compared
to damn Britney Spears. It's more of actually a compliment to her. I say she's pretty, but that just ain't me. She was actually in my dressing room a couple of weeks ago, and she said how my album is one of her favorite albums. And you know, didn't mention that, and I was kind of like, I wonder if she'll say anything about it, but she didn't. She's really sweet to me, so I guess she gets it.
Coldplay frontman Chris Martin played a surprise gig in Trafalgar Square this week. He performed a cover of Jimmy Cliff's Many Rivers to Cross at an event promoting Oxfam's Fair Trade campaign. Coldplay's new album hits shops soon. Forget Big Brother. This is reality TV, Ozzy Osbourne style. The rock legend and his madcap family were filmed 24/7 to make the outrageous series The Osbournes, which hit. Now I can tell you that while I've been abroad, I have seen that, and it is absolutely brilliant. It's hilarious. She much cut up with it. Time now for a CDUK debut from the best connected brothers in pop. You'll know by now that their sister is former step star Lisa, but I bet you didn't know that one of them was once in a group with Will Young and Blues Lee Ryan. They are, of course, Street SL. Country singer Garth Brooks. This is the first single from Ronan's second solo album, Destination. Look out for a UK tour in the spring, but if you can't wait for that, you can see him perform this song exclusively on CDUK next week.
If tomorrow never comes, will she know how much I love her? Did I try in every way to show her?
Listen up, garage fans. This North London 20-year-old is tipped to be the hottest new act on the scene this year. Her name's Ms. Dynamite, and she's already performed with Eminem, Wyclef Jean, and Destiny's Child. Remember, you saw her here first. Recorded at Moby's home studio in New York, this single is taken from his much-anticipated album 18, due for release in May. The star-studded video features cameos from Red Hot Chili Peppers guitarist Dave Navarro, Sean Bean and NSYNC's JC, to name but a few. Shots next week, but right now it's time for a performance of the first single to be taken from one of the most eagerly anticipated albums of the year. In fact, after hearing this band's the latest material from this next band, NME have labelled them the new Radiohead. They were that impressed. Ladies and gentlemen, put your hands together for the brilliant Doves. Stuff from the Doves there, and their album is out at the end of the month. But right now it's competition time, and boy, have we got a prize for you.
We're offering one lucky winner a pair of tickets to Kylie Minogue's spectacular Fever 2002 tour, which kicks off at the end of the month. Not only that, but the winner will get to meet Kylie herself backstage at the show. And on top of that, tour sponsors Vodafone are throwing in a brand new mobile. And Kylie's told us that she'll be glad to record you your very own personalised voicemail message.
Well, what a prize. Make sure that you stay tuned to CD UK this morning, because I'll be giving you the question that you need to answer to win that prize a little bit later on. We'll also be finding out if Gareth Gates is still at the top of the chart. Make sure you stay tuned.
Favourites reunite.
Could that be our boy?
Pop idols go big band with 13 fantastic tracks.
I've got you under my skin.
Pop Idol, the big band album of the year. It's out now.
English.
Part of City UK, and it's time for you to grab a pen and a piece of paper, because it's time for that all-important competition, because you could be on your way to meet Miss Kylie Minogue. Now the question is, what was the name of Kylie's last single? Was it A, In Your Eyes, B, In Your Ears, or C, Up Your Nose? If you think you know the answer, give us a call, 09069 11101. Calls cost just 60p, but you must get permission from whoever pays the bill, and also remember to state the full answer. Now then, it's time to find out if Gareth has done it again. It's time for the CD UK rundown from 10 to 2. With our first new entry, it's Matt Dairy featuring Marcella Woods. She recently won Best Hip Hop Artist at the NME Awards at 9. It's Missy Elliott. He's currently in LA working on new material. Robbie Williams and Faithless frontman Maxi Jazz enter at 8. Ali G and Shaggy fall 3 places to 7. Their album is the biggest selling rock record in the world this year. At 6, it's Nickelback. She's currently on holiday in Miami. Britney Spears is at 5. At 4, it's Faithless featuring Dido. Her next single is out in July. Shakira is at 3. Express 2 featuring ex-Talking Head singer David Byrne is this week's highest new entry at 2. Well done to all those new entries. Next week's CD UK is at the usual time of 11:30, and we've got performances from Ronan Keating, Atomic Kitten, Holly Valance, and Oasis. That's a report.
from NSYNC. And if you missed part of today's show, or you just fancy watching it again, tune in to the repeat on ITV2 at 1:45 p.m. tomorrow. But now I'll leave you with a pop idol who's rapidly becoming one of the biggest chart stars of the year. He's celebrating today because he's beaten Will's three-week run at the top for the fourth week in a row. Gareth Gates is receiving the UK Saturday chart number one. Thank you very much for watching. I'll see you next week. Bye-bye.
I'm red, dump ties ahead, I'm fizzy, 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 refresh your head! Ties are sponsors CD UK.
For a couple of newly deads,
we're very unhappy.
What did you expect? You're dead.
They haven't quite got the hang of scaring people sheetless.
Because those sheets, they don't work.
What's the good of being a ghost if you can't frighten people away?
It's time to call in the expert.
You gotta say my name three times.
Beetlejuice.
Beetlejuice?
Beetlejuice.
What are your qualifications? You like it?
Guaranteed to inject some life into death.
Just say it!
Beetlejuice. Tonight at 9 on ITV2.
Apple and kiwi, and finally blackcurrant last. Make the moment. Vote now at Have a Hotel.
Soccer Sunday, 4:15 this Sunday on Meridian.
We head for Imola for live coverage of the qualifying session for the San Marino Grand Prix. And you can see the race itself tomorrow afternoon on Meridian at 10 past 12.
Go, go, go.